Greetings, yogis. My name is Daniel. This is Daniel Lee Yoga, and thank you for joining me for practice today. As you can see, I'm actually outside at the beach today. I am here at the beach this week, so I thought it would be fun to have classes outside. And if you're watching this live, this was pre-recorded earlier in the day on Tuesday, 7 p.m. It's a little too late. That's right when it gets dark around here. So I thought it would be fun to try and record a little bit earlier while the sun is out and it's just a beautiful day. So this should be fun. It's a little experimental. There might be people that walk by. There might be random birds or animals that show up. Who knows? You might be able to hear the ocean in the background. It's a really nice day. I can feel the breeze and hear the waves, so we'll see what our environment presents to us today. As far as class today, it's fundamental class. In our fundamentals, we kind of break things down, take it nice and slow as we move through the different key component parts and actions of whatever our focus is. And this week, our focus is on our low back. I hear from a lot of people that they have just either low back challenges one way or the other, either pain or limited mobility. So that will be the target area today. So that pretty much equates to lots of twisting and folding and just bringing more awareness to that area in our back to help us kind of loosen things out and hopefully make you feel better. So I want to thank you for joining, and I think we're ready to go ahead and get started. So meet me on your back with your knees slightly bent. I hope wherever you're watching from today, you're having a wonderful day. All right, on your back, just with your knees bent, bring your knees into touch and then separate your feet out wide. Starting our practice in this constructive rest position. Ideally, we'd like to have as much of our spine on our low back. So just gently press into your feet, lift your hips up just an inch or two, and try and draw your tailbone towards the back edge of your mat, and just lay your spine back down on them. Ideally, you want to have as much of your spine on the mat, so just allow yourself to settle in. Have your arms down by your sides, palms can face up. Just take a couple moments to deepen your breathing and allow yourself to bring your awareness to the present here. Just take one more nice, slow, deep breath. And now we'll start to bring some movement into our body. So extend your arms out to a T, palms can face up, arms straight out from the shoulders, or field goal post if you have limited space. And gently let your knees rock from side to side. So keep your feet wide, keep your shoulders rooted. You can let your hips come up as you move from side to side. Just be nice and slow here, very mindful. Just starting to wake up that low back, letting it know that will be the focus of our practice today. Just keep rocking from side to side, one or two more times each way. And coming back to stillness, bring your knees back to center. Separate your knees and your feet back to hips with distance, and then draw your knees into your chest. Let's give them a gentle squeeze. Draw your navel in and down, and let's gently rock from side to side. So we're beginning to massage that low back here. Just keep rocking from side to side, keeping your knees and your feet together. And then come back to stillness. All right, now release the bottoms of your feet back down onto the mat. Have your arms down to your sides. Bring your knees over your ankles so your knees and your feet are both hips width distance. And we'll move into some dynamic bridge poses. So begin by pressing your feet into the mat. Take a nice deep inhale. And exhale as you lift your hips up, pelvis up, chest up into your bridge pose, holding just for a half breath. And then exhale, gently release from the top of your spine, middle of the back, low back, last to arrive. Keep moving that way. On your inhale, lifting up, hips, pelvis, chest. And on your exhale, gently lowering from the top of your spine, middle, low back, last to arrive. Two more times. Inhaling as you lift, following your breath in this movement. And exhale as you gently lower. One more time, press down into your feet. Inhale as you lift your hips up. And then exhale, gently lower from the top of your spine, middle, low back, last to arrive. Option to repeat that, or we'll add the arms. So press down through your feet, take a nice deep inhale, and exhale. All right, press your feet down on your next inhale. Lift your hips up, pelvis up, chest up. Arms come up overhead. Stretch them out nice and long. Thumbs down, pinkies up. And exhale, gently release everything back down. Hips lower, arms lower. Keep moving. Inhale as you lift your hips, pelvis, chest. Arms extend overhead. Thumbs down, pinkies up so the palms face in. And then exhale, gently release everything back down. Two more times on your breath. Again, if it's too much to add your arms at this point, just keep them by your sides, lifting your hips, pelvis, and chest up. We just have one more here, so press down through your feet. Inhale, lifting up. Arms come up overhead. And exhale, gently releasing back down. All right, let's draw both knees into your chest. Give a gentle squeeze again. Keep holding your right knee in. Let's extend and straighten that left leg straight out, releasing the left heel to the mat. Arms wrap around the right shin, flexing both toes, spinning that inner left thigh in and down. Let's draw the right knee in towards your shoulder as you extend that left heel away from the body. Draw the navel in and down, holding for one more breath here. And exhale, release and switch. So now we'll draw the left knee in, extend and straighten the right leg straight out, releasing the right heel to the body, drawing the left knee in. With both feet flexed, spin the inner right thigh in and down. Draw the left knee in as you extend that right heel away from your body, holding for one more breath. And exhale, switch one more time. Let's draw the right knee in, extend and straighten that left leg straight out, flexing both feet. We'll add a little twist here. We won't hold for too long, but let's take the left arm to the outside of that right knee. Extend the right arm straight out like a half T, palm faces up or field goal post. And bring your right knee directly over that right hip and then shin parallel with the mat. We're looking for a 90-degree angle here. Take a nice deep inhale to prepare. And exhale as you drop your right knee over to your left side. You can come on to the outside edge of that left leg. Don't worry about the right knee touching the mat. I know mine doesn't. Just keep the shoulders open. And if that right shoulder popped up on the mat, off the mat, try and reroute down the right shoulder so it's nice and rooted on the mat. Holding here for just one more breath. And let's inhale, draw that knee back up to center. And then exhale as you draw both knees into your chest. We'll switch to the other side. So keep the left knee hugged in, extend and straighten the right leg straight out, flexing both toes. Bring the right arm to the outside of the left knee. Left arm extends straight out to a half T, palm faces up. Bring the left knee over the left hip. Shin is parallel with the mat, 90-degree angle. Take an inhale to prepare. Exhale, let that knee drop off to the right side. So adding a twist, again, you can come onto the right side of that leg. Just try to keep your shoulders rooted. Don't worry about that knee touching the mat. Holding this twist just for one more breath. And then let's inhale, bring that knee back up to center. Exhale, draw both knees back into your chest. Now you have the option to repeat that. Otherwise, we'll bring our knees together and we'll drop both knees at the same time. So if that worked for you last time, that was a little challenge, just repeat that. Otherwise, extend both arms out to a T, palms face up. Bring your knees over your hips, your knees and your feet together, shins parallel with the mat. So we're looking for that 90-degree angle. Now keep your shoulders rooted the entire time. We're just twisting from the navel down. So take a nice deep inhale to prepare. Exhale, gently let your knees fall off to the left side. That right hip can come up. Just use your abdominal muscles to make this nice and slow. Holding just for a breath. Don't worry about the knees touching. And on your next inhale, bring them back up to center. Use those abdominal muscles. Take an inhale to prepare. Exhale, let's drop to the right side this time. You can hover or drop the knees down, whatever your mobility is today. Stay for a breath. And let's inhale back to center, knees over hips. Make those shins parallel with the mat. Take an inhale to prepare. Exhale, let them drop to the left one last time, each side. Holding for a breath here. Keep that right shoulder rooted. Take a nice deep inhale. And exhale, draw them back to center. We'll drop to the other side. Take an inhale to prepare. And exhale, drop the knees off to the right. Again, using your abdominal muscles, that's what helps to protect your low back. So we're starting to warm them up. Holding here for just another half breath. And let's inhale back to center, knees over hips, shins parallel to the mat. And then draw your knees into your chest one last time. And from here, let's cross our ankles. And if you'd like, hold your hands behind your thighs. We're coming up to a seat. If you want to roll up and down your spine a couple times first, you can tuck your chin and gently start to roll up and down the entire length of your spine a couple times. And then with your legs crossed, you can come forward and sit up into a seat. Otherwise, just let your legs fall off to the side and meet me in a seat, whatever way works for you. All right, have your ankles underneath your knees, your shins crossed, sit bones are rooted, and just place your arms or your palms resting on tops of your knees. If you feel like you're falling back here and you need a little bit of elevation, you can roll up your mat. If you have blocks or a mat, you can sit on top of those as well. Wherever you are, just root down through your sit bones, rise up through the crown of your head. Soften your shoulders away from your ears. Take a nice deep inhale and exhale. One more inhale and exhale. All right, from here, we'll start to bring some movement. So let's extend the arms out to the sides. On your next inhale, bring the arms up overhead, palms face each other. And exhale, release the arms out and down, back down to the sides. Three more times. Inhale, bring the arms up overhead. And exhale, release down. Twice more. Inhale, arms overhead, soften those shoulders down. Exhale, release the arms out and down. One more time. Inhale, bring the arms up overhead. And exhale, release the arms out and down. Inhale as you bring them back overhead. This time we'll add a twist. So on your exhale, twist to your right, release both arms to the outside of your right thigh. We're holding here. We're a little warmed up, so we can hold this. You can maybe start to walk your right hand back. Really root down through your sit bones. Create a nice long spine before you twist to any extreme here. You can use that left arm as a slight lever on your right knee, adding to the twist. Initiating from the navel up, and then maybe you turn your neck to look over that right shoulder. I'm looking out over the dunes and looking at some beautiful waves in the background. Really is a beautiful day here today. Take a nice deep inhale and exhale, release. Release back to center. Inhale as you bring your arms back up overhead, palms face each other. Other side. So exhale as you turn to your left. Release both arms to the outside of your left thigh this time. Again, keep both sit bones rooted. You can walk this left arm back a little more if you'd like, using the right arm as a lever. But really root down through your sit bones, rise up through the crown of your head. Inhale as you lengthen. Exhale, twisting from the navel up. Take another nice deep inhale. And exhale, maybe start to turn your neck to look over the left shoulder. Let's hold here for two more nice, slow, deep breaths. One more breath here. And exhale as you gently release back to center. Let's inhale, bring both arms overhead, and exhale, hands down through center and down to the sides. Take a nice deep inhale and exhale. All right, let's switch the clasp of your, or switch whichever shin is in front. Bring the opposite shin in front. Have your heels back underneath your knees, arms down to the sides. Adding a side lean now. So inhale as you bring the arms up overhead. Soften those shoulders away from the ears. Now drop your right arm down, fingertips or palm to the mat. Inhale as you send the left fingertips up to the sky. And on your exhale, side bend to the right. So keep both sit bones rooted, especially that left sit bone that wants to pop up off the mat. If you can, keep your bicep next to your ear. Shoulders are square forward, so we're not adding a twist, just a side bend here. So we're looking for space in between both ribs, lengthening through both sides of the body. If you'd like, you can walk those right fingertips out, maybe add a little bit more of a lean here, holding for two more breaths. One more breath here. Let's come back to center on your inhale, bring both arms overhead. Exhale, drop your left arm down, fingertips or palm to the mat. Inhale as you send your right fingertips to the sky. And exhale, side bend over the left side this time. Keep your bicep next to your ear. If you'd like, you can walk those left fingertips or palms out. Just make sure that right sit bone stays rooted. So if you feel like it's coming up, just reduce how much you're side bending here. Keep your shoulders squared forward, bicep next to ear, creating length in both sides of the body, especially this left side. So try and find space between each rib, holding for two more nice, slow, deep breaths here. One more breath. And let's inhale, bring both arms back overhead, and exhale, hands down through center and down to the sides. All right, before we move on, let's work on our wrists a little bit. So let's clasp the fingers together, bring the wrist to touch, and just start to make circles with your wrists, almost like a figure eight or an infinity symbol. You can try to keep your elbows together. That makes it a little bit more of a stretch here, a little more of a challenge. But really, we're just warming up the wrist for the rest of our practice. All right, let's begin to slow move in the opposite direction here. Just allowing your wrist to loosen up, warm up. And come back to stillness. Let's separate the hands, separate the fingers, but keep the hands together, base of the wrist touching. We'll make circles this way. So you try to keep the base of your palm or your wrist touching as you roll your arms through. So it's hard to describe, but just try to keep the base of your hand touching the entire time. Try to avoid hitting yourself in the face or the chin as your fingers come through. Just starting in your first direction, do a couple more here. Then begin to slow, let's move in the opposite direction. Sometimes this can just be a mental exercise as much as it is a physical. All right, you can cease that. Release your arms down to the sides, and now we'll move into tabletop. Either place your arms in front of you, roll over your knees, or just send your legs off to the side and meet me in a tabletop. So in a tabletop, you have your wrists below your shoulders, knees below your hips, tops of the feet to the mat. Fingers are nice and spread, pressing down to the base of each finger in each palm, and gently pressing the tops of the feet into the mat. Firm your triceps in to have your elbow creases start to face forward. Try to draw your tailbone down, send the crown of your head forward to create a nice long spine, even right here. Hugging the navel in and up, take a nice deep inhale and exhale. Let's add our cow cats. On your next inhale, drop your navel, tailbone lifts, heart comes forward, look up. And on your exhale, rounding the back, shoulders separate, head hangs heavy, cat pose. Keep going, moving on your breath. So on your inhales, you drop your navel, tailbone lifts, heart forward, chin up. Exhale, rounding the back, really press down through your hands, draw the navel in and up. Keep moving. Maybe you move a little bit faster, a little bit slower. Just allow your breath to set the pace here. Taking the time to move mindfully and noticing how you feel as you move through here. Let's do two more times each way, taking your time. Just a great way to warm up the spine here. And once you've finished your last one, meet me back in a nice neutral spine in your tabletop. And now we'll add a spinal twist, but on the side this time. So we'll draw the right shoulder towards the right hip and let the neck come with it. So you start to look back towards your right toes, still keeping the neck nice and long, but drawing that right shoulder in towards the right hip. Holding for one more breath here. And exhale, gently release. We'll move to the other side. So take an inhale to prepare. Exhale, draw that left shoulder towards the left hip. Let the neck come with it. Maybe you take a gaze back towards that left foot. Just keep gently pressing the feet into the mat, firming the triceps in. And exhale, gently release. One more time, each side. Draw the right shoulder towards the right hip. Maybe you gaze back to look towards those right toes. Keep pressing down to the base of each finger and each palm. And release back to center. Moving to the other side one last time. Left shoulder draws towards that left hip. Keep drawing the navel in and up. Neck is nice and long, maybe gazing back towards the toes. On your next inhale, gently releasing back down into your tabletop. And keeping the tops of the feet on the mat, let's send our hips back towards our heels, come into child's pose. If you prefer another child's pose with your knees wider or your big toes touching, feel free to take the version that works for you. Either way, sending your hips back towards your heels and releasing your forehead down towards the mat. If your forehead doesn't quite reach the mat, you can lift your hips up off your heels, or you can place a block or fold up your mat or a towel underneath your forehead. Just have your arms stretched out nice and long and start to take a couple slow, deep breaths here in your child's pose. Knowing that child's pose should always be a place of resting and recovery, staying away from any pain. You can make it active here, but know that this is always an option for you to come back to in your practice if you need to reset or regroup or just take a couple seconds or breaths to yourself. So take a nice deep inhale and exhale. All right, we're staying low, but lift the forehead up and we'll walk the arms off to the right side of your mat, adding a side lean in our child's pose. So once you walk your hands off to the right side of your mat, release your forehead back down. Try to keep that left hip rooted down. Arms are still nice and long, biceps next to ears. Staying here for one more breath. And then lifting your forehead back up, walking back to center, staying for a breath here. And then walk your hands off to the left side, extending the arms nice and long, releasing your forehead back down to whatever you're grounding. Keeping the biceps next to ears. Root that right hip back down towards the right heel. Hold for one more breath. And lifting the forehead up, coming back to center in your child's pose. And you have the option to repeat that. Otherwise, we'll move on and we'll add an option for a bind behind our back with a twist. So, starting in your child's pose in the center, lifting your forehead up, walking your hands off to the right where we were before. So stay here, or lifting your forehead up, send the right arm behind your back, internally rotating, bring the back of your hand to your low back. If you'd like, that right arm can come a little bit farther forward. Right fingertips may be tucked towards that left thigh. Now open the right shoulder out. Try to draw the right ribs up to the sky, rolling the left ribs under. And then maybe you start to gaze to look over that right shoulder up towards the sky. Holding for one more breath here in your twist. And exhale as you gently release, extend that right arm back out. Let's have everyone walk back towards the center, and we'll switch to the other side. So walking the hands off to the left, option to stay here if this is enough for you. Otherwise, to move on, lifting your forehead up, extend the left arm behind, bring the back of the left hand to the low back, staying here, or going a little further, adding a bind Left fingertips towards that right thigh. Drawing the left shoulder up towards the sky. Roll the right ribs under as you open those left ribs to the sky. Maybe you turn your neck to look over the left shoulders. One more breath here in your twist. And exhale as you gently lower. Walking back to center in your child's pose. Let's gently lift the hips up off the heels, but keep your forearms on the mat. Come into a forearm tabletop here. So just like in our tabletop, this time we have our elbows underneath our shoulders here. Tops of the feet are still to the mat, and you're still hugging your navel in and up to create a nice long spine. Let's add our cow cats here and notice how that might feel a little different from our typical tabletop. So on your inhale, drop your navel, tailbone lift, heart comes forward, look up. And on your exhale, rounding the back, shoulders separate, head hangs heavy. Let's do three more times on your breaths. Again, be slow and mindful here, taking notice how this feels, how this compares to your typical cat-cow pose. And knowing this is always an option, this can give your wrists a little bit of a break. It just gives an alternative for your traditional cat-cow. Let's do one more time each way. And then coming back to stillness in your forearm tabletop, take a nice deep inhale and exhale. All right, from your forearm tabletop, lift back up into your full tabletop, shoulders over wrists. Curl the right toes under, extend and straighten that right leg back. Curl the left toes under, extend and straighten back. Come into your plank pose, shoulders over wrists. You always have the option to drop your knees down in your plank pose. We're holding here for two breaths. Fingers are still nice and spread, firming the triceps in so the elbow creases start to face forward. One more breath. Now let's everyone have your hips lift up to the sky. Press your chest back towards your thighs. Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. It's our first downward facing dog, so you can take your dog for a walk, lifting one heel, lifting the other, pedaling out the legs. If a down dog is too much and you want to drop down to your knees in tabletop, no, that's always an option. You can always drop into child's pose as well. If you're in tabletop, you can pedal out your legs here. So whatever option you're choosing, just try and move and groove, listen to your body. And let's come back to stillness, meeting in our down dog or our tabletop. Let's inhale as we gaze forward, bend the knees, exhale, walk or step towards the top of your mat. Take as many steps as you need to, meet at the top of your mat in your forward fold, feet are hips width distance. You can measure by bringing two fists together, place them in between your feet or your knees. Fingers and palms hang heavy, either rest on the mat, shin or thighs. Let your chin tuck and your head hang heavy. Have your knees be generously bent here. You can rest your chest on your thighs. The more your knees bent, the more this becomes a lower back stretch. So we take a little bit out of the hamstring by bending our knees and allow our low back to release more. Pressing down into the feet, try to lift your hips up to the sky as the crown of your head draws down towards the mat. Now we'll add our ragdoll pose, grabbing opposite elbows. Let your biceps hang in between both, or your ears hang in between both biceps. And if you'd like, you can gently start to rock from side to side. This might allow you to loosen up that low back a little more. Just keep pressing the feet into the mat. Your legs are still active and engaged, spinning the inner thighs in and back. Let's switch whichever forearm is on top. And you can keep rocking from side to side if movement calls to you for now. All right, and coming back to center, let's release both arms down. We'll come up to standing, but nice and slow. So press down through your feet. Start to inhale as you stack one vertebrae at a time, lifting up. Your chin is the last thing to arrive. Take your time coming up. And once you're fully up to standing, let's just roll those shoulders up and down a couple times. And then switch opposite direction, bring them back and forward. All right, coming back to stillness. Let's meet me back at the top of your mat. Feet are hips width distance, heels directly behind the center toes. They're nice and parallel. Arms are down to the sides, palms face forward. Draw your tailbone down towards your heels as you lift your frontal hip points up to the front bottom ribs. Broaden through the collarbones as you draw the shoulder blades down your back. Chin is parallel to the mat. Take a nice deep inhale and exhale. Let's add some more movement. Inhale, bringing the arms up overhead, palms face each other. Let's soften the shoulders down away from the ears, holding for a breath here. And on your exhale, hinge forward, forward fold. Knees can bend. We've been here before. So again, you can bend the knees as much as you'd like, releasing your fingertips or palms to your feet, your shins, or your thighs. Press down into your feet, bring your hands to the tops of your shins, and lift halfway on your inhale. Halfway lift. Chin is slightly tucked, gazes out past your feet, extending through all sides of the torso, maybe starting to straighten your legs. And on your exhale, hinge forward, forward fold. Stay here for a breath, spinning the inner thighs in and back. Feet are engaged, drawing the kneecaps up. Let's come back up to standing. Press down through your feet. On your inhale, bring the arms back up overhead. Palms face each other. Stay for a breath. Again, soften the shoulders down away from your ears. And exhale, hands down through center and down to your sides. Take a nice deep inhale and exhale. Let's move to one breath, one movement. Inhale, bring your arms up overhead. Exhale, hinge forward, forward fold. Inhale, lifting halfway. And exhale, forward fold. Press down into your feet. Inhale, lift the arms out and up overhead. Palms face each other. Exhale, hands down through center, down to the sides. One more time. Inhale, Urdhva Hastasana. Exhale, hinge forward, Uttanasana. Inhale, halfway lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, forward fold. Press down into your feet. Inhale, raise the arms back up overhead. Urdhva Hastasana. And exhale, hands down through center. Samasthiti. Releasing the arms down to the sides. Take a nice deep inhale. And exhale. All right, so you can stay at the top of your mat. I'm just turning to face the camera here. Bring your big toes to touch and your heels separated, maybe an inch or two. Arms down to the sides. Adding a little twist in our standing posture here. So take a nice deep inhale and exhale. Let's extend the arms out shoulder width height, palms face each other. I'm sorry, palms face away. Bending the elbows, keep the biceps at shoulder height, palms still facing away. Adding a twist here. So we'll keep our lower body just as it is and try and twist just from the navel up. You may not go that far, which is fine. So we'll inhale as we prepare. And exhale, twist from the navel up, turn to your right. So try to keep your pelvis facing forward and you're just turning the torso with the shoulders and the arms. Maybe you start to turn your neck to look over those right fingertips. But can you tell without even looking? Is that left hip drawing forward? Maybe you can draw it back slightly. Pressing down into both feet, holding for one more breath. Gently returning back to center. Make sure your arms are still up at field goal pose. Take a nice deep inhale to prepare a nice long spine. And exhale, turn to your left this time. You can notice how you're turning just from the navel up. A lot of times your hips want to initiate the movement, but we're trying to have the middle of the back start there, come up through the neck, with that being the last thing to turn. Maybe you look over the left fingertips. Keep pressing down into the feet. Maybe you draw the right hip back, left hip forward. Hold for one more breath. And inhale as you release back to center. Bring both arms overhead, palms face each other. And exhale, hands down through center and down to the sides. Take a nice deep inhale and exhale. All right, back at the top of your mat if you're not already there. Bring your big toes to touch and your heels separated. Arms down to the sides. Take a nice deep inhale, raise both arms up overhead. Exhale, hinge forward, forward fold. Inhale, lifting halfway. And exhale, forward fold. This time, stay low. Plant both palms. Keep your left foot forward. Step your right leg back. Drop your right knee down towards the mat. You can keep the back toes curled or uncurled. Place the right palm directly underneath that right shoulder and extend the left arm out to the side, palm faces down. Firm both legs in towards each other. Make sure that left knee tracks over the left ankle. Take an inhale to prepare. Exhale, twist. Send the left arm up to the sky. Again, twisting from the navel up, keeping the hips firming in towards each other. Maybe rotate the pinky side edge of that left hand forward so the palm faces forward. Last option is to turn the neck to look up towards the left fingertips. Holding here for two breaths. Keep firming the thighs in towards each other. One more breath here. And exhale, gently release that left arm back down. With the right toes curled under, lift the right knee up. Step the right foot up to the top of the mat. Take as many steps as you need to. Big toes touch, heels separate. On your inhale, lifting halfway, nice long spine. And exhale, hinge forward, forward fold. Stay low, keep your right foot forward this time. Step your left foot back, switching to the other side. Dropping the left knee down. Keeping the toes curled under or top of the left foot to the mat. Notice if you had any issues with balancing on the first side, maybe you separate your feet a little bit wider apart to give you a little bit more of a foundation to balance on. We'll place the left wrist under that left shoulder, extend the right arm out to the side, right palm faces down, take a nice deep inhale to prepare, and exhale, send the right fingertips up to the sky, firm the thighs in towards each other. Maybe start to rotate that pinky side edge of the right hand forward so the palm faces forward. Allowing the shoulder to open, drawing the right ribs up to the sky, left ribs roll under. Last option is to turn the neck to look up at those fingertips, holding for two long, slow, deep breaths here. One more breath. And exhale as you gently release that right arm back down. With the left toes curled under, press the heel back, lift the left knee up. Step the left foot up to meet the right foot. Take as many steps as you need. Back to the top, big toes touch, heels separate. Inhale, lift halfway. And exhale, gently release, coming back up to standing. Press down through your feet. Inhale, bring the arms up overhead, palms face each other. And exhale, hands down through center. And down to the sides. Take a nice deep inhale and exhale. All right, back at the top of your mat, separate your feet to hips width distance. Have your heels behind the center toes and arms down to the sides. Take a nice deep inhale and exhale. Now on your next inhale, let's bend the knees, send the hips back, arms forward, chair pose. Biceps next to ears, palms face each other. Make sure you can gaze down and see your toes. And with your feet hips width distance, your knees should be the same distance apart. Still firming the thighs in towards each other. Take a nice deep inhale and exhale. So we'll add a twist here. So just like when we were standing, we'll try not to move our hips and turn and twist just from the navel up. So inhale to prepare, nice long spine. Exhale, twist to your right, open the right arm out behind you. So twisting from the navel up, try to keep the arms up at shoulder height. Palms face away from your body. Maybe you turn the neck to look over those right fingertips. Draw that left hip back and the right hip forward. Make sure those knees stay in line with the feet, holding for one more breath. And let's inhale, come back to center in your chair pose. Stay for a breath as you inhale. And exhale. Now inhale to prepare. I know it's a lot to hold. We got this. Exhale, twist to the left this time. Bring that left arm behind you, twisting only from the navel up, drawing the right hip back, both palms face away from each other, away from you. Keep drawing the right hip back. Left hip draws forward. Make sure the knees stay in line with the ankles. Maybe you turn your neck to look over those left fingertips. Let's hold for one more breath. Inhale back to center chair pose. And exhale, hinge forward, forward fold. Stay here for two breaths. Just let your thighs release a little bit here. I know that was tough to get through, but you got it. Hang out here for one more breath. All right, let's inhale as we lift halfway, nice long spine, hands to the shins. Exhale, forward fold. One more time to reset. So inhale, lift halfway, Ardha Uttanasana, nice long spine. And exhale, forward fold. This time we'll stay low. Let's plant your palms, step your right foot back, step your left foot back into your plank pose. From here, drop down to your knees, shift forward, bend the elbows back, lower all the way to the mat. Tops of the feet come to the mat, press your feet down, hips down. On your inhale, lift your head up, chest up, baby cobra. Holding for two breaths. Release your tailbone towards your heels, send your heart forward, look for more length rather than height. And on your exhale, gently release back down. Keep your knees down, curl the toes under, press up into knees down plank pose. And then lift your hips up and back into your downward facing dog. Holding your down dog for just a couple breaths here. Press your chest back towards your thighs. Again, you always have the option to drop down to your knees. Pressing the heels back and down for one more breath. All right, let's inhale as we gaze forward. And then send the right foot up to the top of the mat. So take as many steps as you need to. Right foot draws up to the top. Now we're in our high lunge, so keep that back knee off the mat this time. Right knee over right ankle. Press down through your feet, and on your inhale, lift your torso up, lift your arms up overhead. From here, exhale as you drop your hands down through center, and we're shifting forward into a balancing pose. So you can watch me first before you come. So I'm going to shift forward, drop, or lift my back foot up, and my left knee comes parallel with my hip. So to prepare, make sure that right knee tucks over the right ankle, draw the right hip back, left hip forward. Take a nice deep inhale to prepare, and exhale, hinge forward, press up all the back heel, draw the left knee up in towards your parallel with your thigh. Now, adding a twist here if you'd like. So, if you want to stay here, you can. Next option is to extend your arms out to a field goal post, so palms face forward, bend the elbows, palms face forward still. Keep releasing the tailbone down. If you want to add your twist, bring the right arm to the outside of the left knee. Take a nice deep inhale to prepare. And exhale, straighten the left arm, twist from the navel up towards the left knee. Remember to keep the pelvis facing forward, turning just from the navel up. Shoulders aim to square with the long edge side of your mat. Keep pressing down into the heel. Maybe you turn your neck to look over those left fingertips. Holding for one more breath here. Wherever you are, turn back to center. Bring both arms overhead. And exhale, release the foot, release the arms down through center and down to the sides. Feet hips width distance. Take a nice deep inhale. And exhale. Let's inhale, bring both arms overhead. Exhale, hinge forward, forward fold. Inhale, lifting halfway, nice long spine. And exhale, forward fold. Let's plant both palms, step both feet back, and lift your hips up and back to downward facing dog. From here, we'll move to the other side. So, gaze forward, step your left foot up to the top of the mat. High lunge, keep your left knee tracking on top of the left ankle. Right knee is above the mat, lifted. Pressing back through the right heel. Now press down through both feet, and on your inhale, lift your torso up, lift your arms up. Get nice and balanced here. Release your hands down through the center of your chest. Draw that left thigh back, right thigh forward. Shoulders are squared forward. Release your tailbone down, draw the frontal hip points up, and you know where we're going. So take a nice deep inhale to prepare. Exhale, hinge forward, press up off the back heel, lift the right knee up to hip height, flexing that right foot. Option one to stay here. Option two, add your field goal post arms. Extend the arms out, palms face away, bending the elbows into field goal post. Again, stay here if you like. Keep drawing the tailbone down, pressing the heel into the mat. Or if you want to add your balancing twist, send the left arm to the outside of the right knee. Keep the pelvis facing forward. Take a nice deep inhale to prepare. And exhale, twist from the navel up. Extend and straighten the right arm back behind you, shoulder height. Palm faces away, twisting from the navel up. Draw the right shoulder back. Maybe the gaze turns to look out over those right fingertips. Breathe here for two breaths. Wherever you are, keep pressing out through the heel. One more breath. And on your inhale, turn back to center. Bring both arms overhead. And exhale, release the foot, release the arms. Take a nice deep inhale. And exhale. All right. So meet me back down on your mat. Let's come into child's pose, actually. So your version of child's pose with your knees together or separated. Big toes can be touching or they can be in hips width distance. Send your hips back toward your heels. Release your forehead down to the mat. Option for your arms to either stay long out in front of you or if you want to send them back beside your ankles, have your palms face up. Sometimes that can allow your shoulders to release a little bit more here. Just hold for a couple more deep breaths here in your child's pose. One more breath. All right, send your arms back out in front of you. Lift your forehead up. Lift your hips up. Send your legs off to the side. Come to a seat with your legs out in front of you. Now bend your knees, separate your knees out wide, and bring the bottoms of your feet to touch, coming into bound angle Baddha Konasana pose. You have the option to draw your heels in. You can either do very close, or they can be farther away, whatever your preference is today. And again, whatever you choose, if you feel like you're falling back, you can place some elevation under your sit bones here as well. Just choose what works for you. Hands can rest around your shins or your feet. Root down through your sit bones, send the crown of your head up towards the sky. Soften your shoulders away from your ears, draw your navel in and up. If you can draw your knees away from each other down towards the mat, allow yourself to settle in here. You can either stay here upright if you'd like to add a forward fold. Take a nice deep inhale as you raise your arms up overhead, palms face each other. Exhale, keep a nice long spine as you hinge forward. Send your heart towards your toes. You can release your hands down shoulder width distance to the mat or to the ground. And again, avoid rounding too much here. We want to keep a nice long spine, sending your heart forward. Wherever you are, we'll hold for three slow, deep breaths. Staying for one more breath here. And if you're in your forward fold, begin to walk your hands back, lift your torso back up. And then everyone, use your palms underneath the outsides of your knees to gently draw your knees in towards each other. Bring the bottoms of your feet to the mat, and we'll gently lower onto our spines. So if you're not at the top of your mat, use your hands to send your hips up towards your heels, and then gently lower by holding onto your shins or your thighs. Try to take your time, engage in your core muscles to lower as slowly as you can. And once you come onto the mat, bring your heels back underneath your knees. Knees and feet are both hips width distance. Coming now into our bridge pose, we'll hold this time. So we were dynamic at the top of class, and now we'll be able to hold our bridge. Make sure those ankles are underneath the knees. Pressing down into the feet, take a nice deep inhale to prepare. Exhale, lift your hips up, pelvis up, chest up, bridge pose. Keep pressing the triceps down. Spin the inner thighs in and down towards the mat. Keeps the knees hips width distance. They always want to separate out wider than they should. Draw the tailbone towards the backs of the knees. Take two more nice, slow, deep breaths. Maybe you lift a little bit higher. One more breath here. And exhale as you gently lower from the top of your spine, middle of the back. Low back is the last to arrive. Take a nice deep inhale and exhale. All right. This time, draw the right knee into your chest. Extend and straighten that left leg straight out, flexing both feet. We were here before at the beginning of class. Let's wrap both hands around the shin. Draw that right knee in as we extend that left heel away from the body. Now we'll add our twist, but this time we'll hold a little bit longer. So extend the right arm out to a T, palm faces up. Bring the right knee above the hip, left arm to the outside of the right knee. Right shin is parallel with the mat. Take a nice deep inhale to prepare. And exhale, let the knee drop over to the left side. You can come onto the outside edge of that left foot and leg. Just try to keep the right shoulder rooted on the mat. Just lifting my arm to block the sun. That's nice and bright overhead. It feels great. Last option, if you'd like, you can turn your neck to look over your right fingertips. Wherever you are, just take two more slow, deep breaths in your full spinal twist here. Try to keep that right knee at least up at hip height. Both feet are flexed. Allow yourself to settle in for one more breath here. Now bring your gaze back up to center. Bring the right knee back up to center. Let's draw both knees into your chest. And we'll switch to the other side. So extend the right leg long. Left leg out, left arm out to the side. Palm faces up to a T or a field goal post. Bring the left knee over the left hip. Shin is parallel with the mat. Foot is flexed. Right arm to the outside of the left knee. Take an inhale to prepare. And exhale, let that knee drop over to the right. Keep the knee up at hip height. Don't worry about the right knee hitting the mat. Just try to keep your left shoulder rooted and turn your neck to look over the left fingertips if you'd like. Again, you can be on the outside edge of that right leg and foot. Just keep that left shoulder rooted on the mat. Allow yourself to settle in for two more slow, deep breaths here. Last breath. Let's turn back to center. Let's draw both knees back in towards your chest. Give them a nice, gentle squeeze here. Let's roll on our spine, gently sway from side to side, massaging that low back again, giving it some love here with the knees drawn in. All right, coming back to center, separate the knees out wide. Happy baby. Bring the bottoms of your feet up towards the sky. And your arms can either wrap around the outsides of your thighs or your shins. If they grab the outsides of your feet, have your elbows to the inside of your knees. Notice if your tailbone popped up, see if you can reroute your tailbone back down on the mat. Keep your shoulders down towards the mat as well. Draw the knees and the bottoms of the feet down towards the ground. And if you'd like, you can gently sway from side to side in your happy baby. And let's come back to stillness in the center. Release the clasp of your feet or your legs. Bring the knees back into center. Knees and feet touch, drawing the knees in. Let's lift the shoulders and the back of the head off the mat. Come into an egg shape. Squeeze everything in together. One last breath here. Squeeze everything. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. And exhale, release. Extend the legs long. Extend the arms long overhead. Point the toes away from the body. Extend the fingertips nice and long. One last full body stretch, stretch, stretch. And exhale, release. And the arms down to the sides. Palms face up. Legs nice and long, let the knees and the feet fall out to the side. Begin to settle into your final pose of practice here, Shavasana pose. If you prefer any other option to complete your practice, feel free to do whatever calls to you today. Just wherever you are, allow yourself to settle in. Now's the time to really enjoy the fruits of your labor for showing up today on your mat. Allow yourself to release and breathe into any areas that you may need to send some attention to, maybe soften and root down towards the mat. Allow your knees and your feet to fall out. Let your shoulders be heavy. Soften the muscles around your face and your jaw. You can allow your eyes to close or your gaze to soften. And finally, just release any control over the breath. Just be. Now let's bring some awareness back into your body. You can wiggle your fingers and your toes. Rotate your wrists and your ankles. Switch directions in those rotations. Come back to stillness for one last breath here on your back. And now begin to gently bend the knees in toward your chest as you roll over to one side of your body. Let your top arm rest on your bottom, top knee rest on your bottom. Stay for a breath here on your side. And now, keeping your eyes softened or your gaze closed, use your top arm to press yourself up into a comfortable cross-legged seat to complete your practice today. In your comfortable seat, you can rest your palms on tops of your knees. Palms can face up or bring your hands into the center of your chest. Let's all take a nice deep inhale in together. Through the mouth, exhale. Thank you all for joining me for your practice today. The light and love in me acknowledges and honors the light and love in each one of you. Thank you. Peace. I'm so grateful for all of you who decided to watch today, wherever you are, at what time, if you're watching this on Tuesday when it premieres or later sometime. I hope you enjoyed, and hopefully the sound's okay. Again, I'm not sure if you heard any of the environment. It's a little bit of wind here. You can definitely hear the waves. A couple of people walking by, so we didn't have too many interruptions, but I hope you enjoyed. This one was really, really personal to me and a lot of friends and family who have shared that they have a lot of lower back issues or challenges. And so my goal today was to give you all some different tools that you can use to try and alleviate those issues. If you ever have any questions, you can always reach out to me either in the comments, the video description has links to reach out to me on Instagram or email. And as far as next class, that will be Friday at 7 p.m. I'll probably pre-record the session as well. That will be an all levels class, so we'll ramp things up a little bit, but still provide plenty of modifications for anyone at any skill level to complete the practice. So again, if you'd like to donate, that link is in the video description to help fund and fight racial and social justice. Otherwise, I will just plan to see you next time in class. So again, my name is Daniel with Daniel Lee Yoga, signing off from the beach down here in North Carolina. Hope you have a wonderful rest of the week. Thank you so much for joining. See you next time. Peace.